नमस्कार, दिलीप सिंह एडवोकेट. यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम टू माय चैनल जर्नी ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया. एंड टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग अ न्यू वीडियो सीरीज दैट इज विद द नेम करंट केसेस सीरीज. एंड दिस इज पार्ट वन ऑफ दैट सीरीज. द नेम ऑफ दिस वीडियो इज सस्पेंशन ऑफ रेंट इन लॉकडाउन. अनडाउटेडली द लॉकडाउन हैज क्रिएटेड ए सीरियस कॉम्प्लिकेशंस ऑफ बिजनेस अक्रॉस द ग्लोब. The parties of contractual relationship are at loss, and they are trying to redefine their terms of relation after seeing the various outcomes of this COVID-19 lockdown. The court of law is also finding very difficult in creating a level playing field among the all stakeholders. And however, the court is conscious of the hardships faced by the parties due to this lockdown. An important question came before Delhi High Court: whether this lockdown would entitle tenants to claim waiver or suspension of rent. The matter was Ramanand versus Dr. Girish Soni, and in rent revision number 447 of 2017, and decided this matter was decided on 21st of May 2020. The judgment is delivered by Justice Pratibha M. Singh. She is a judge having deep understanding and wide knowledge on contractual law. The brief facts of the matter is, it is a landlord-tenant dispute for a property, a shop situated in Khan Market, a very premium area of Delhi, New Delhi. And in 2008, the landlord filed an eviction petition on the ground of bona fide need before assistant rent controller, additional rent controller, and the petition was allowed and an eviction order was passed on 18th March 2017. The tenant filed a rent appeal before rent control tribunal, and that was dismissed. Thereafter, the matter reached to High Court in the rent revision. High Court granted an interim stay on the eviction order. And with a direction to pay a sum of ₹3,50,000 as monthly occupation charges. Learned counsel for landlord has the main submission in this case that the force majeure does not apply in the case, which is governed by Delhi Rent Control Act, as it is a statutory tenancy. And in this particular case, when the order has already been passed, eviction order, so it will not apply in case. The legal provisions in this case which are applicable are mainly at Section 32 and Section 56 of Indian Contract Act 1872 and Section 108 Clause B Subclause E of the Transfer of Property Act 1882. Let us see Section 32 of the Contract Act, which deals with the contingent contract. It says, contingent contracts to do or not to do anything if an uncertain future event happens cannot be enforced by law unless and until the event happened. That event has happened. If that particular event becomes impossible, such contract becomes void. So only on happening an event the contract is operational. In this case, there is knowledge of that event and that finds it mentioned in the agreement. Whereas Section 56 deals with agreement to do impossible act. An agreement to do an act impossible in itself is void. A contract to do an act which after contract is made becomes impossible, or by reason of some event which promisor could not prevent unlawful, becomes void when the act becomes impossible or unlawful. It was held by the court that waiver of or non-payment of monthly rent under Section 32 of Contract Act is available as per the terms of the contract, which has a force majeure clause. So the agreement should have a force majeure clause. Why this sections were dealt, because at the very beginning the court said that there are various kinds of lease agreements, short term, long term, and so in it is particularly stated that where this force majeure clause is mentioned, then only section 32 of Contract Acts comes into play. Then the question arises, what is force majeure? Force majeure is a French term which literally means greater force. So it is an event or effect that can be neither anticipated nor controlled, and also includes both acts of nature such like flood, hurricane, and acts of people like riots, strikes, and wars. So the force majeure refers to a clause in the agreement that is included in contract to remove liability for natural and unavoidable catastrophes that interrupt the expected course of events and prevents the parties from fulfilling obligations. So the catch point is that it is for the purpose of removing the liability, or in the contract as per the anticipated course of, if it doesn't go anticipated course of action. The High Court heavily relied on the decision of Supreme Court in Energy Watchdog versus CERC 2017 volume 14 SCC 18. In this judgment of Energy Watchdog, it was held that in case of contract itself contains in express or implied terms relating to a force majeure condition, the same shall be governed by section 32 of the Contract Act. It means force majeure comes into picture only if it is a part of the contract, then contract apply the provision of 32. The Supreme Court also held that section 56 of the Contract Act, which deals with the impossibility of performance, would apply in the case where a force majeure event occurs outside the contract. So this is the difference. Here the performance of contract becomes impossible due to an event, impossible or unlawful due to an event which is not a part of the contract. That event is not is mentioned in that contract. So the fact remains, there must be a clause in contract. If the contract contains a clause providing for some kind of waiver or suspension of the rent, then only could the tenant claim the same. If there is no such, the tenant is not in a condition to claim the suspension or waiver of the rent. However, the High Court clarified that if the tenant wishes to retain the premises and there was no clause of giving respite to the tenant, rent would be payable. So here the catch is retaining of the premises by the tenant. The High Court held that the absence of a force majeure clause or a remission clause, a tenant may attempt to invoke the doctrine of frustration of contract or the impossibility of the performance as per the section 56 of Contract Act. But such invocation would not be applicable because in the view of or the legal settled legal position, what has been dealt by the court by reciting the judgment of legal Energy Watch case. The other judgment of Supreme Court, which was relied by the Delhi High Court in this Ramanand case, is Raja Dhruv Dev Chand versus Raja Harmohinder Singh, that is AIR 1968, Supreme Court 1024. The Supreme Court held in this case, that Section 56 of the Contract Act would not apply to lease agreements. Why so? Because Supreme Court drawn a distinction between a completed conveyance and an executory contract. Section 56 does not apply to a completed transfer as it is in the case of lease, and the lease is considered as a completed conveyance. So Section 56 cannot be invoked to claim waiver, suspension or exemption from payment of rent इन होटल लीला वेंचर लिमिटेड वर्सेज एयरपोर्ट अथॉरिटी 2016 ब्रैकेट 160 DRJ 186 वेरी डिवीजन बेंच ऑफ दिल्ली हाई कोर्ट हेल्ड दैट ए कॉन्ट्रैक्ट फॉर लीज वेयर अंडर द लेसी ऑब्टेन्स पोजीशन फ्रॉम द लेसर इज एन एग्जीक्यूटेड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इट्स ए कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इज कंप्लीट सो इट वॉज हेल्ड दैट सिंस पीरियोडिकल पेमेंट ऑफ रेंट इज ए टर्म ऑफ द एग्रीमेंट द एग्रीड कंसिडरेशन हैज टू बी पेड एंड सच रेंट विल नॉट बी सच and such rent will not be discharged merely because it turns out to be or it happens to be difficult for tenant to pay rent or to perform his part of obligation because he cannot resign from the contract of the said reason. In view of the aforementioned precedents, the High Court took the view that Section 56 of the agreement, where the executed contracts where the lease agreements are executed contracts and not executory contracts. So, this the benefit of it will not go to the tenant. The other section which was relied by High Court in this case is Section 108 Clause B Subclause E of the Transfer of Property Act 1882. It says, I am quoting it here, if by fire, tempest or flood or violence of an army or of a mob or otherwise other irresistible force, any material part of the property be wholly destroyed or rendered substantially and permanently unfit for the purpose for which it was let, the lease shall be at the option of lessee be void. So provided that if the injury be occasioned by wrongful act or default of the lessee, he shall not be entitled to avail himself the benefit of that provision. So the High Court observed that in absence of contract or contractual stipulations, the provision of the Property Act will govern the tenancies and leases. It was stated that doctrine of force majeure and the rights and liabilities of lessee are enumerated in section 108B of the Property Act. As per the said provision, on the occurrence of any stipulations stated in section 108B clause subclause E will make such lease void at the option of the lessee. But here again the issue was that the possession was the lessee had to surrender the possession. If the lessee decides to retain the position, the situation differs. Important aspect of decision in Raja Dhruv case, which was relied by Honorable High Court in the present case, where the Supreme Court held that temporary non-use by the tenant of the leased premises due to any factor would not entitle the tenant to invoke Section 108 of Property Act. So here the situation was that due to lockdown, the suspension or waiver of rent was claimed. But this judgment of Supreme Court categorically says that if there is no stipulated provision in the Rent Act, he will not be entitled. It is settled provision that unless lessee avoids the lease, the obligation contained in 108 Clause B and subclause I cannot be avoided. The High Court held that for a lessee to seek protection under Section 108 Clause B subclause E of the Property Act, there has to be a complete destruction of the property, which is permanent in nature and due to the force majeure clause. And the property must not be in condition to be used for the purpose for which it was taken on rent. The High Court took the view that temporary non-use of a premises due to lockdown cannot be construed as rendering the lease void and therefore a tenant cannot avoid payment of rent. Then qua the plea of tenants, extension of doctrine of suspension of rent on account of lockdown due to COVID-19, the High Court considered the following factors to determine. Now the question is coming to what extent this extension doctrine can be seen. The High Court considered the following questions: whether the tenant is entitled to relief of suspension of rent. For that, the following factors were considered by High Court to decide whether he is related and whether the tenant is entitled for suspension of rent. The first, nature of property. In the present case, it is a commercial property in prime commercial area of Khan Market. The second question was, second factor was considered, financial and social status of the parties. In the present case, landlord is a dentist having eviction order in his favor and he wants to run his dispensary there, his clinic there, whereas the tenant runs a footwear shop and he has been in use on position of this shop since 1975 at a monthly rent of merely 300 rupees. So the amount of rent at present is rupees 3,50,000 decided by court as a condition for grant of stay and continued use and occupation of that by the tenants, because the tenant does not want to vacate the plot, vacate the shop, and he wishes to continue. And it was a tacit understanding, tacit consent on the part of tenant to use this premises at the monthly rent of this. The other factors which was considered here was that after passing of the eviction order, the tenant becomes an unauthorized occupant. So this is also against the tenant. The other contract, any other contractual conditions. It was observed since this is a statutory tenancy, so there is no other contractual obligations that permitted that non-payment of or suspension of rent in case of any eventuality. The next point which was considered by court was the protection under the executive orders, because it was the defense and it was the argument on behalf of the tenant that there are several executive orders and where the tenants are protected from paying the rent during this lockdown period. The court observed that the tenants were not covered under such orders, as therefore could not claim relief of such orders, because these all orders are yet to be tested legally. The High Court rejected the tenant's application of suspension of rent, but allowed a certain degree of relaxation in rescheduling of payment of rent owing to the lockdown. So now we see that the judgment based itself on a certain fact and circumstances, because as earlier observed by the court in this case that there are various kinds of agreement, there can be various kinds of agreement, various kinds of lease understandings. Sometimes the rent is paid in the terms of profit and sharing profit and all that. So here this judgment is particularly based on its fact and circumstances. So different law will be developed in different course of action when the other fact, in other cases where the different separate, different conditions and different facts and circumstances come before the court. My standing says that the lockdown due to pandemic is an unprecedented situation and its impact on business world is very serious. It needs to be considered as an independent factor. In other words, the legality and legal consequences of pandemic are a new subject and the development of its jurisprudence is to take time. I would like to end this video with the lines which are written in the judgment of Ramanand by Justice Pratibha Singh. In the very first para, which para I quote, that will give the entire concept which even the court was having in its mind at the time of penning down this judgment. The COVID-19 pandemic has had large scale implications for human life. Contractual relationships and jurisdictional relationships between the parties are severely affected due to lockdown. The questions as to whether the lockdown would entitle tenant to claim waiver or exemption from payment of rent or suspension of rent is bound to arise in thousands of cases across the country. Though there can be no standard rule that can be prescribed to address these cases, some broad parameters can be kept under consideration in order to determine the manner in which the issue that arises can be resolved. So what we are seeing from this para that even the court is aware of the huge problem and implications and its aftermath are to be due to this pandemic and lockdown. Let us see in future the different judgments will be coming dealing with the different aspects of tenancy and lease. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked my effort, please subscribe to my channel. Namaskar.